National Federation of the Blind. Live the life you want through science, technology, engineering, and math.
Blind STEM professionals share their experience.
Hi, I'm Cindy Bennett, and I'm a blind PhD student at the University of Washington in the Department of Human-Centered Design and Engineering.
Hi, I'm Gary Wunder, and I'm a blind computer scientist.
Hi, my name is Mark Calcero, and I'm a blind PhD student in biomedical engineering.
Hi, I'm Jamie, and I'm studying to be a physicist, and I'm blind.
Hi, I'm Dr. Carrie Cipollo, and I'm a blind chemist.
What are some of the alternative techniques that you use in your work?
Some of the most prominent alternative techniques that I use are, first of all, Braille. Braille is the way that I'm literate, and especially when reading STEM content, Braille is very helpful for me, as screen readers don't always announce STEM content, again, non-textual characters or equations, correctly. So reading them in Braille helps me to understand syntax a lot more quickly. Plus, when I'm presenting, Braille allows me to look in my audience rather than down at my notes.
Well, I use Braille instead of print. I listen to and read Braille produced by a screen reader and a refreshable Braille display, such as the one I have here on my lap. I use a regular keyboard sometimes. I use the Braille keyboard here for data entry. Sometimes I even use speech, but there's nothing like Braille for getting down syntax, and that's really important in programming.
To read journal articles, I use a typical screen reader, like JAWS, and of course to write, I also use JAWS.
A lot of abstract ideas in physics are represented with pictures, diagrams, or graphs. I use a tactile drawing board in my studies and in work so that I can draw these diagrams myself and also read diagrams that my colleagues draw for me. An example would be if I had a ball and I wanted to throw it straight into the air. From the moment the ball leaves my hand, it's going to increase in height very quickly until it gets to about the top of its path, and then it's going to slow down and then start coming back down towards my hands faster and faster and faster until I catch it again. And in physics, we can represent this with a parabola. And with the tactile drawing board, I can feel the parabola and get an idea of that trajectory.
So in my teaching, I use hard copy Braille notes in conjunction with a laptop computer and a projector with PowerPoint. I'm also not shy to use a whiteboard and a marker to write specific calculations or equations. And of course, I use my cane to get around the classroom. I ask students to say their first name when they're seeking the floor to ask a question.
Another alternative technique that I use is, since I'm in the field of human-centered design, we often prototype technologies before we build them. So my prototyping experience is usually a lot more tactile. So I'm bringing in like fabrics, 3D objects, and textures to build my prototypes. And I actually think that alternative technique is helpful for everyone, but it's something that I use probably a little bit earlier in the prototyping process than my colleagues.
For my actual lab science, I use a variety of lowbrow techniques, nothing too fancy, but some of the larger ones that I have developed. I'm currently trying to develop an automated cell culture system that allows you to perform cell culture without needing to use, without using vision, in the sense that you can set up your experiment as you need it and it will automatically process everything that you need. And then in addition to analyzing microscopy images, I've developed a number of algorithms that can parse through the images and pull out particular features that you need and quantitatively analyze those features.
And that's how blind people do STEM. For more information, visit blindscience.org.